Yes, so now we are going to start with a 2-wire DC distributor, which is generally, I just wanted to highlight that, a 2-wire DC distributor AB, which is fed at both ends. At feeding point A, the voltage is maintained at 230 volt, and at B, you are having 235 volt. What it means is, you are drawing a DC distributor at points A and B, you are being maintained at V1 and V2. So these are the different voltage levels that are being present there. So once I have this different voltage levels, I'll be going for the differential voltage technique there. So what it means is, so you are having the voltage at point B to act as a load, the final load, and voltage at A, which is the incoming voltage, generally what I speak here. So now if I want to analyze this given DC distributor, it is being maintained at 2 points, which you need to find out is, it is concentrated loading. It is concentrated loading. Second one, you are having the unequal voltages. So you are having the unequal voltages. And third one, you need to find out the resistance per section initially. So these are the three things that you need to remember. So, and the first two things are quite normal, and the total length of the distributor is 200 meter. The length of AB is said to be 200 meter, which is being given there. So now what you can see is, you are having different levels of voltages at point A and point B. So next, what you are going to have is different loading points, say C, D, E, F, which is being present there. So point C, point D, point E, and point F, which is being present there. So these are the currents, say I1, I2, I3, and next one current, which is being given there as I4. So I1, I2, I3, and I4, which is being present there as 25 amperes, 50 amperes, 30 amperes, and 40 amperes respectively. And these points are being displaced at 75 meter, sorry, first one is the 50 meter, next one is the 75 meter, next one you are having the 100 meter, so next one you are having the 150 meter length that is being given there from point A, that is the final point F there. So what you are going to do now is to find the current in section AC, so that is the current in current feeding at point A, that is IA current, to find current entering at point A. Second one, what you are going to find out is to find out the minimum potential point. So this is what it has been there in these terms which are being listed out there. So now what is being given there is, you have to find out what is the current entering the point A. Next one, what you are going to find out is the minimum potential point. So as we know that the minimum potential point can be found out easily by making use of the change in the direction of the current there. So here what you have to remember is, so you're having two different voltage levels which are being maintained. So let's go to the solution now quickly. And I just wanted to find out the first one, which is the resistance. Okay, first one, what is being given there is the resistance of each section, which is to be found out. So resistance of each section. Okay, so how do you find out the resistance of each section? So resistance of each section can be found out by, that is, you are having the per kilometer length. So first one, what you are going to find out is, given the resistance per kilometer of one conductor. I repeat, it is the resistance per kilometer of one conductor, which is 0.3 ohm. Okay, so for 1 kilometer of one conductor, you have the resistance to be 0.3 ohm. So imagine the length of the conductor is said to be 1000 meters, and you have the one conductor which is being present there, that is generally taken as 0.3 ohm. So how do you find out the resistance of both the conductors, resistance of both conductors? Okay, so that is for 1000 meter per 1000 meter length of the line. So per 1000 meter length of the distributor or the line, distributor or the line, generally I'll take it. So resistance of 1000 meter, resistance of 1000 meter length of distributor, in the brackets let me give it as both wires. Okay, both wire refers to here as go and return conductor, go and return conductors which are being present there. So in spite of doing all these things here, so what we can generally find out is you can have such conductors being given there in the numerical problems, and what you are going to do there is you are going to find out the values of such systems which are being present there. So what you are going to do here is you are going to find out the resistance of such thing as 2 into 0.3. So that is 0.6 ohm that is being present there. Okay, so that is what you are going to find out. So which is 2, that is the both the wires resistance are being given there. So 2, that is 0.3. When you multiply it, you will be getting there as 0.6, which is being present there. So now if you want to find out the resistance of each section, okay, resistance of each section can be found out in this manner. So resistance of section AC, resistance of section AC, that is RAC, which is to be found out, RAC. If you want to find out the resistance of that section, what you are going to do, you are going to find out 0.6, which is ohm per 1000 kilometer length of the line, divided by 1000 and multiply by the length of that section. What is that length of the section there? That is 50 meter. So this is what you are going to get, 520s are that you are going to get. So 0.6 divided by 20. Okay, that's what the answer is. So let us find out what is 0.6 divided by 20. 0.6 divided by 20. So 0.03 ohm. So that is what you are going to get, 0.03 ohm that is being present here. So this is the resistance of section AC. So this is per 1000 kilometer. So what I wrote here, and this is the length of the section AC, length of section AC or the distance of section AC that is being present there. So what you are going to do now is you are going to have such sections being written, and you are going to do that for each and every section there. So you have such sections there as RAC, okay, RAC, next you have RCD, next you have RDE which is being present there, next you have REF that is being present there, next what you are going to have is RFB, okay, RFB that is being present there. So RAC, RCD, RDE, REF and RFB. So what is that? 0.03 ohm, next one 0.015 ohm, next one 0.015 ohm that is being present there, next one 0.03 ohm, next one you are having 0.03 ohm that is being present there. As I told you, all these things, yeah, sorry, this one and this one, okay, so and remaining these three are said to be equal there. So these are the resistance of each sections, resistance of each sections are being listed out here, resistance of each sections are being listed out. So what you are going to do now is you are going to have the voltage at B and voltage at A. So let me find out what is the current entering the section AC. So first what you need to do is voltage at B will be equal to voltage at A minus drop along the distributor AB, drop along the distributor AB, drop along the distributor AB, okay, along the DC distributor. Let me write it as DC distributor AB there. So this is the voltage at B is 235, that is 230 minus the drop along the DC distributor AB there. So that is what you are going to find out. So you are having the current IA being entering, that is IA current entering at point A. Current entering at point A, that is being given out there. So these are the terms that is being present. So that is IA into RAC plus, what is the value of the current? IA minus 25 ampere. So the value of current is, the value of resistance is RCD. Okay. Next, what you are going to find out is plus IA minus 75, that is times RDE plus IA minus 105, IA minus 105 into REF plus IA minus 145 into RFP, IA minus 145 into RFB. So these are the individual drops across different sections that is being present there. Okay. So once I have the sections, I have the loading points as 4 loading points, and I have the different sections being listed out there. So now what you are going to find is to solve for IA. Solve for IA. So the value of current IA is said to be 33.34 amperes. 33.34 amperes. Okay. So that is what you are going to get there. So now what is to be done is you have to find out the currents in various sections of the distributor and the minimum voltage and the point at which the occurs. So minimum voltage here refers to the minimum consumer level voltage, and the point, what are the points which are being listed out? Either it is C, D, E or F. So out of these 4 points, you are going to find out which is the minimum potential point there. So given the value of IA, so the same current flows through the section IAC also. So next, what you are going to find out, currents in different sections, currents in different sections. Okay. Currents in different sections. First one, that is IAC. IAC, what you are going to find it out as 33.34. So 33.34 amperes. Second one, what you are going to get it as 8.34. So that is ICD. That is 8.34 amperes. Third one, what you are going to get there as, that is IDE. IDE. That is 41.66 amperes. Next, IEF, that is 71.66 amperes. So that is what you are going to get. So IEF. Next, IFB. IFB, that is 111.66 amperes. So what you are going to get there as from A to C. Next one, C to D. So this one, what is being present there here? It is from E to D. So there is a change in the current. So if IDE is minus 41.66 amperes, it would be from D to E there. Okay. So there is a change in the direction of current. There is a change in the direction of current. Okay. At point D there. So next one, again here you have F to E there. Next, again you are having it from B to F. So this is where you will be having a change in the current direction, and all these things are having a negative direction if you take it from a reference point A. If you have taken it from reference point B, it is having the positive sign there. So 3, 4 and 5, what I've listed out here, so we'll have a positive sign when the current is moving from E to D, F to E and B to F. So there is a change in, and this point D is said to be the minimum potential point. So minimum potential point there. So this is what it has been listed out, and the minimum potential point D is known. So now, what is to be made here is, so to find out the minimum consumer voltage there. So as I told you, to find minimum consumer voltage, minimum consumer voltage, minimum consumer voltage, that is VD, minimum consumer voltage VD. Okay, so what you are going to find out is VA, okay, that is VA minus the drop in section AC, drop in section AC plus next one, drop in section CD, drop in section CD. So that is VD there. Okay, so VA, what is the voltage level? 230 volt minus drop in section AC and drop in section CD there. So that is what you are going to find out is 33.34. Next, RAC, what is RAC? 0.03. So plus drop in section CD there, so that you are having it as 8.34. next, you are having RCD as 0.015. so that is what you are going to get there as VD. What you are going to get at the end is 228.875 volts. So this is the minimum consumer voltage. So this is what you are going to get there. So this is the final thing where you are going to get there as the minimum consumer voltage there. So this value of the voltage is said to be having the minimum consumer voltage level. As you can see that, so it is generally between 230 volt. Okay, so it is between 230 volt to 235 volt. So that is the voltage range that is to be maintained there. So this is a numerical problem having the different voltage levels which is being present there. Okay, so hope you have understood this problem, and we'll end this session now.